Welcome to the class. In this part 3 of the video series on contract of agency, let's discuss three things: rights of principal, duties of principal, and termination of agency. Okay. First, rights of principal. The first right of principal, we can say, is to repudiate the contract whenever the principal finds that the actions of the agent is negligent or unauthorized or at in any case unsatisfactory or against the rules of the contract. Principal has a right to repudiate the contract, but while repudiating, the principal has to give a reasonable notice to the agent. Okay, so he can repudiate the contract by giving a reasonable notice. And what is reasonable is depending upon the nature of the contract. We have discussed this before also. Reasonableness is an abstract thing. It depends, it varies from situation to situation. Okay, now he has also a right to ratify a contract. See, for example, an agent, even though he was not appointed as an agent, starts acting as an agent, doing certain activities. Those activities, even though are unauthorized, can become valid if the principal ratifies it. So principal can give validity to the actions of the agent later and thereby create a contract of agency. So ratification of contract is also a right of the principal. Even though when it has started, there was no contract of agency and without authority the agent was acting, but that action can be recognized by the principal through any of the gesture or through any of the words by the principal. Okay. That means it can be an implied ratification or an expressed ratification. But there are certain principles which are applicable in case of ratification. For example, both the parties, like agent and the principal, should have clear knowledge about the contract and the ratification, and no third party interest is violated by this kind of ratification. Okay, so subject to those rules, principal has a right to ratify the contract. Okay, now principal has an authority to revoke the contract also, because even before the expiry of the term or even before the completion of the work, the principal has a right to revoke the contract in case, as I told you, if the activities of the agent is not satisfactory or for any other satisfactory reasons, principal can revoke the notice, but principal must give a reasonable notice. And the lawful expenditure which agent has incurred as a part of the contract of agency also has to be indemnified or compensated by the principal according to the terms of the contract. Okay, because after the agent performing certain activities, agent incurring certain liabilities, if the principal revokes, it shouldn't result in an injustice. So those things are to be seen. But having said that, principal has a right to revoke the contract. Only thing, he has to follow the rules. Okay. Now, principal has a right to get the profit of the business, isn't it? Yes, whatever profit the agent makes, because the business belongs to principal, the profit also belongs to principal. And the same way, the loss also belongs to principal. Principal is responsible for the profit and the loss. Okay. Now, principal, I told you when we discussed about contract of agency and the duties of agents, the agent has a duty to render proper account and maintain proper account. And not only that, he has to report to the principal. Same way, the principal has a right to demand the accounts. Principal has a right to refuse the remuneration if the agent's actions are such that he has taken money or he has incurred certain liability which is not according to the terms of the contract. So in order to make good such losses, the principal has a right to refuse remuneration to the agent also. Okay, so is that clear? These are the rights of the principal, and as we have seen in many contracts like bailment, like pledge, the rights of the principal are the duties of agents. Okay, now let's see what are the duties of principal. Okay, duties of principal. Mainly there are three duties of principal. The first one is to indemnify any loss as a part of the contract of agency. Whatever losses lawfully incurred by the agent has to be indemnified by the principal. He has a right duty to compensate any other expenditure incurred as a part of exercising the duty of agent. Principal has to compensate for all the related expenditures also. Duty to remunerate. Again, there can be contract of agency without remuneration, but that depends on what is written in the contract. So, as per the terms of the contract, principal has a duty to remunerate the agent as well. Is it clear? So, main duties are three: duty to indemnify, duty to compensate, and duty to remunerate. Okay, now we are going to discuss, like any other contract, contract of agency also has to be terminated. Yes, so what is the procedure for termination of agency is what we are going to discuss. Modes of termination of agency. Okay, mainly there are two grounds of agency. They are by act of parties and by operation of law. Let's see, by act of parties means both the agent and the principal make an agreement, and through a mutual agreement they can terminate the contract of agency. No problem, it is mutual consent. They have to create a new agreement to terminate the earlier contract of agency. Okay, now what next? Revocation. As we have already seen, the principal has a right to revoke the contract of agency, and therefore by giving a reasonable notice, principal can revoke the agency. Same thing is applicable for a contract of for an agent also. That means if the agent does not want to continue with the agency, he can also renunciate the contract of agency. Same way, he has to give a reasonable notice to the principal. Okay, so both of them together by creating an agreement, agent by renunciation and principal by revocation, contract of agency can be terminated by the act of parties. Okay, now by operation of law. When the business of contract of agency is complete, say for example A was appointed as an agent of B for selling B's house. A found out a buyer, the house is sold, business is complete. Okay, that means contract of agency is automatically terminated. Now, death, insanity or insolvency of agent or principal will terminate a contract of agency. Expiry of the term. If the agent is appointed for 1 year, after 1 year the term is expired and automatically the contract is discharged. So therefore, if any contract of agency is for a particular period of time, once that period is over, contract is also automatically terminated. Destruction of the subject matter. A has appointed B to buy a horse, and by the time the agent is exercising his authority, the horse died. Subject matter is destroyed. Therefore, contract of agency is automatically terminated. Okay, now the last one is dissolution. See, for example, principal can be a company, agent can also be a company. For example, LIC, Life Insurance Corporation, is appointing agents. LIC is the principal. which is a company. So similarly, a principal can be a company, agent can also be a company, and dissolution of a company is considered to be the death of the party, and therefore dissolution of a company, if the company is a principal or an agent, will automatically terminate the contract of agency. Is that clear? So in this video, we have discussed about rights of principal, duties of principal, and modes of termination of contract of agency. Okay, I hope it's clear to you. See in another video with another topic. Till then, bye.